Hi, I'm Stefanie Perrin, a Board Certified Behavior Analyst at Brett DiNovi Associates, and today's topic is comparing functional analysis and paired choice assessment. These are the task list items that will be covered. Functional analyses seek to demonstrate a functional relationship between the independent and dependent variable. Due to the lack of understanding of the variables maintaining target behavior, we see an increase in a treatment's ineffectiveness. If you know why the problem behavior is occurring, you can tailor your replacement behaviors via communication or an alternative response. So some reasons that you may choose to conduct a pair choice assessment is if the individual does not display the problem behavior during the functional analysis. Behavior occurs infrequently or at low levels and does not repeat in subsequent conditions, or if the behavior is covert. Inconclusive results lead practitioners to rely on descriptive assessments and other indirect techniques, and the behavior plan does not include function-based interventions. Berg and colleagues in 2007 conducted a study, and the purpose of this study was to examine if the reinforcers identified for problem behavior via a functional analysis were the same as appropriate behavior identified in the choice assessment. The secondary purpose of this study was to conduct the functional analysis and the choice assessment in a school setting, and the teacher was the therapist. Four students participated in the study, which was conducted in a classroom. The students stood at the midline in front of two tables at the start of each session. The teacher provided a brief demonstration of the activity associated with each side. The opportunity for the student to make a choice was repeated verbally every 90 seconds, and the individual was allowed to cross back and forth between each of the sides. However, he or she was not allowed to take the materials from one side to the other. The functional analysis was conducted using a multi-element design. A concurrent schedules design was used to evaluate each participant's allocation of time to the two sides of the room, and the sessions were interspersed across days for each student, and the materials were used in both assessments. Results of the functional analysis of problem behavior and paired choice assessment were compared to determine whether the same social reinforcers were identified for problem behavior as an appropriate response at the time allocation. Three of the four participants, the results of the two assessments matched, in the sense that the same class of reinforcement maintained both sets of behavior. So some of the benefits of the paired choice assessment is that it's quick and easy. It also looks at preference. It identified preferred items and activity, which can then be used to promote the individual's desired replacement behavior and decrease problem behavior using, for example, differential reinforcement procedures. The paired choice assessment is beneficial for several reasons. It's better to conduct this assessment than relying on descriptive assessments and indirect techniques because it relies on direct measurement of behavior and looks at how the behavior changes based on environmental events. And in this case, choice. In addition, it also provides a basis for an intervention to strengthen appropriate behavior. For example, Quigley and colleagues used a choice assessment to inform the design of a behavior intervention plan for a 9-year-old boy diagnosed with autism. The participant demonstrated zero rates of problem behavior during an FA. Choice assessment results indicated a preference for adult attention and preferred items. Using these results, an intervention consisting of DRA plus FCT resulted in an increased choice of work, time engaged in work, and work completion. I hope you enjoyed this topic. Please make sure you subscribe to our channel, and I look forward to reading your comments.